This is Keepsakes, the podcast. I'm Jay Agonoy.
This is episode 77 of the podcast. Thank you for listening. And I now have with me Jasteanne Benito. Hello.
Hi, Jay. Thank you for having me here. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much.
I know Jasteanne as a cosplayer, so kindly introduce yourself first.
Okay, so during college, I'm a cosplayer. They say I'm a professional cosplayer, which is parang for me, it's just some sort of a hobby, but I get earnings from it. So basically, when I was in college, I cosplay and then pinapagpatuloy ko yung pag-aaral ko. I have this scholarship until such time na I transitioned into digital marketing and helping Filipino realtors get more revenue and targeting those people outside the country na mag-invest dito sa Pilipinas.
Mm-hmm. This is actually a rare story of someone who who starts a hobby and then eventually mapupunta sa another phase in life. On my side as an technical guy sa events, we're also doing some sort of marketing. So medyo relate tayo dito. The last time that we did this kind of discussion was with Ainatsumi, my semblante, Diane Marisa Bandeja, together with Gary Montejo, co-hosting from Cebu. They're into either events or marketing. So this is why we'll continue that part, and to Jasteanne, we'll continue listening to stories of hobbyists turned basically businessmen or entrepreneurs or career makers, kumbaga, no? So, right. Okay, so the first segment for this discussion is your cosplay career. So tell us more about your cosplay journey. Nagsimula ka and then kung kailan ka nag-stop, so on and so forth.
Alright. So, nagsimula ako nung first year college ako. I was so fun with dolls, BJD dolls to be exact. And I really like their eyes, their lips, and I wanted to be one. So, I like dressing up that time. I really wanted to look cute. And though I am into anime naman that time, hindi ako masyadong ano sa cosplay kasi I haven't really heard of anyone in our province, which is Tacloban, it's a really small city, na nagko-cosplay. I really thought it's just in Manila and Cebu. And then one day, there's this friend of mine, sabi niya, I see you doing this some sort of cute stuff in Facebook. Nagpo-post ka na para kang manika. And then I was like, yeah, what about it? And then he said na, you know what? Baka gusto mo mag-join sa ano namin, group namin. There's this cosplay event. And Tacloban is a small cosplay event. Until such time na I actually attended this cosplay event in UP Tacloban, which is palaging doon naman parang hiniheld yung cosplay event nila. It's very small. It's just few people from Ormoc and then Tacloban nag-merge and then they have this small event. Tapos, that time, I actually went as a ball-jointed doll, which is pretty funny kasi everyone is on cosplay, but of course, it's acceptable naman na you go as a parang whatever you like. So I went there, I have this small doll, and then I have this, siguro yung nakita kong skirt sa store. It was just like for 90 pesos, and I got this ukay-ukay, some sort of a parang, it's just a polo na parang may design na parang cute siya. And then I got my hair. I didn't have a wig and then just a bangs. So afternoon, I had fun. Nagpo-photo shoot na during that event. And I really got parang drawn to the photo shoot thing of cosplay. And I said, wow, this is very fun. Until such time na I got really, really active in that group. And then, minsan, nag-cosplay kami and then nag-photoshoot kami kasi walang events doon. Until such time that I actually met someone and then in-introduce niya ako sa Cebu and Cebu and the cosplay there. So I went there to Taco Fest 2017. And there I cosplayed my first ever cosplay, which is si... God, I forgot the name. Anyway, I forgot the name. But it was like a very memorable experience sa akin kasi I got this 150 wig and then this... siguro it was just a parang tinahe na ukay-ukay tapos parang kinostumize. Then there I really had fun and nag-develop na siya. Doon na ako nag-start magtahe because I really love cosplay but I didn't really had enough budget for it. So what I did was I tried learning sewing and then I post my pictures and there I finally parang say na I was really active on cosplay and it became my world.
Yeah. So okay, moving back to your first cosplay, was this a magical girl? Was this a character from a mobile game?
It was a magical girl. Was it
a popular series?
It's a popular series. I keep forgetting it was
M? Does it start with the M or an S?
Sino ba yung may ano dito? Yung nakaganon siya. Si Magical, ano, and she's like, parang nakaganon siya. Yung may ano dito, sa eyes.
Meron sa eyes. Okay. Kasi all I think of, if we talk about magical girls, Sailor Moon, Madoka Magica, ano pa ba? Nanoha. Also, no, Nanoha.
Ano, yung naka-violet na hair, and then naka-red siya na skirt. May ano siya dito, may blind siya dito na white, yung parang yung eyes na tinatakpan niya. Yung tinatakpan niya yung eyes niya and then she parang yung nangyayari is hindi siya magical girl but parang high school siya pero grade school yung isip niya. I keep forgetting the name kasi super tagal na nun eh.
Mm-mm. That was 2014, ano? And how was Cebu at that time? 2017, sorry. So, how was it? Gano ba karami ang tao at that time?
Oh God, there were a lot of people. And when I say a lot, it's like, it's one of the biggest event kasi yun eh, sa Otaku Fest. And you know how crazy that is.
Yes.
And it's quite, parang let's say, hindi naman siya alat na mag-aano na lahat ng space but more of like a lot. Parang ganun.
Ayun. So okay, moving forward 2017. It's been 3 years. How many costumes do you have during your cosplay journey? How many na yung na-cosplay mo?
Oh my God, I can't. Let's say...
Bilang ba sa kamay?
Hindi na bilang sa kamay eh. Kasi ang dami ng tinahi ko. Ang dami ng pinotoshoot ko. And I actually, parang very invested ako kasi gusto ko kahit ano, magta-travel pa talaga para lang ma-cosplay ko. I cosplayed si Mitsuha. Then we had to go to Baguio.
Kasi Baguio!
Imagine from Tacloban to Baguio. So I really wanted that feel. And ganun ako ka-very, let's say, parang very passionate in cosplay that if hindi ko nakukuha yung parang gusto ko na look, I feel really down. It's like some sort of a, parang naging mundo ko siya eh, because I wasn't really that active in college na parang, you know, they have squads. I'm more of like the girl who go to school and then after going to school, babalik sa bahay, magtatahe.
So, kumbaga, like you're part of the going home club if we talk about the Japanese school system. No? Mm-hmm. So, you eventually become a traveler during your journey. So ilan, aside from Baguio and Cebu, ilang lugar na yung napuntahan mo?
Na nagko-cosplay ako? Or
yes.
So kapag nagko-cosplay ako, siguro was, that was, siguro yung Baguio, and then I actually also was planning to go here sa Manila for a cosplay, kaso nga lang nag-lockdown. So,
ayaw.
Then, Cebu. Always, it's almost like Cebu, and then pupunta ako sa mga iba't ibang mga medyo malalayo sa amin na umaabot lang ng 2 hours yung biyahe. Just for me to have a shoot. Parang ganun lang.
So more on photo shoots kind, you're less on going to conventions.
Yeah, actually parang mas naging ano ako sa photo shoot because doon ako nag-earn eh. Mm. I started nung nagsusu ako, tapos parang pinupost ko yung pictures ko, sabi ko bakit hindi ako mag-coffee? Palagi naman ako nagpo-post. Mm. And then ayun, I started doing coffee, so nagsusuwa ko ng clothes ko, and then ipopost ko, tapos yung ibang mga photos ko, nilalagay ko sa coffee para may mag-subscribe sa akin, until such time na it became really a good source of income din.
Mm-hmm. So speaking of coffee, kasi I can only think of a handful of cosplayers who are doing this earning model, ano? Yung coffee, Patreon, and siguro mga photos. In Manila, there are cosplayers who are selling their photo prints. I think that's the case sa'yo, tama?
So, photo prints for me is not, parang hindi ko talaga siya bet. So, I didn't really had a parang photo prints. But I'm more on like digital prints. So, basically, yung ginagawa ko is I have exclusive photos. And then, if you wanna buy this, I'll send the parang digital photo sa'yo in private na hindi pwede ma-access ng iba because you're the person who bought it.
Mm, I see. So to give an estimate of since you're doing this model, kasi I'm although I'm quite familiar with the photo prints model kasi through observation to my friends, can you tell us how much are you earning doing this?
So before, since I was really active in cosplay, I was actually earning pretty decent. Umaabot siya ng 20,000, and the highest is 50,000 a month.
That value, no? So a month.
Yeah,
I was supposed to think that it's kind of surprising, pero that's the net eh. How about that's the gross rather. So yung net is 5 figures monthly. Mm. Kasi we talk about gross and net dito eh. So gross meaning the total accumulated, and then the net yung natira sa'yo after all paying all these expenses na associated with that.
Okay. Actually, hindi naman kasi masyadong malaki yung nakukuha ng parang cosplay sa akin. It's more of like parang rewarding siya, kumbaga. Parang hindi ko siya nagiging, parang, uy, babayarin ko to. So, but yeah, more of like that. And then, during that time, talagang nakapag-ipon ako, and I was supporting myself. So basically, siguro mga around that range pa rin. More of like,
So yeah, speaking of cosplay, before you went through this, before you get introduced to cosplay, of course you have a lot, you could have a lot of inspirations in your cosplay journey. Can you tell us who are your inspirations in this journey? Sino yung mga nakasalumuha mo na mga makikilala natin na sikat? Kasi yun yung usual ng mga tanong sa cosplayers, have you met Aloja? Have you met Myrtle? So sa'yo, how about you?
Siguro, I haven't really met Aloja, but before I was like newbie ako, tapos parang Aloja commented on my cosplays, yung maybes. siguro yun lang yung parang achievement ko sa kanya. But siguro yung pinaka parang na-meet ko na parang gusto kong cosplayer, she's not like Mertel, she's not like Aludia na parang diba super sikat na sa Pilipinas, but more of like mas bet ko sa community ngayon si, oh my god.
Hey, no, does it start with a J?
Actually, mas yung bet ko talaga si Ainatsumi. I've been a follower.
Ay, oh, oh. Yan niya. Shout out sa ano. Ang galing din niya eh. If ano, to recap the past episode, the third Twitch thing that we did together with Diane and Mice, she is into events. And she's into MNL48. So, my goodness. What she does and the waifu moments and the project waifu, talagang ano eh. She's into something eh. She's
very into something. Mm-hmm.
Very, very.
And then her works, I can really say na it's quite amazing. Though, parang yung iba is like, bakit ganun? Bakit lewd? But me, I also do lewds. This is how I generated money, by the way, doing lewds. And I can really tell na it's not easy. It's not just putting lingerie. It's not just doing pa-sexy mode. It's about, there's a specific parang professionalism dun sa ano na yun, sa parang let's say sa genre na yun. It's more of like paano mo i-maintain yung body mo, paano ka magpo-pose, paano ka gaganda sa ano na to. Mm-hmm. And even though you will say na parang magpapa-sexy ka lang naman, no, it's not. Kasi hindi yung photo, it's really hard to do an angle na parang enticing siya sa tingin na hindi siya mukhang walaswa, but more of like art. And that's the thing I really love about her work.
So, speaking of doing these lewds, of course, hindi ko maiwasang itanong ito. Have you, during that time, experienced a-holes who are taking advantage, mga ganon? Or have you, ano, how do you deal with stupid people doing stupid things?
So, hindi talaga maiwasan eh. There will be some people na parang, you know, magbabastusin ka sa mga posts mo. And I even had to, parang may Facebook lang ako na para sa cosplay, and I had to block my classmates kasi I don't want them knowing it. So, kasi para sa akin, the more na pinaka-hard talaga i-deal with is not those a-hole people. It's not those people na parang nakikita mo sa internet. It's more of the people who know you personally.
Who knew you first before you do all these things? Yes. Like, I can somehow relate. Kasi kahit siguro mga kamag-anak ko, paano ko explain na I'm doing this YouTube podcast stuff sa ano ko? It's only my mom who knows this. And parang iba yung paningin na. Of course, there's this stereotypical ano bang ginagawa mo, ganyan. So moving back to you. So so you're saying you experience those kind of stuff. Tama.
I experienced those kind of stuff. I experienced people mocking me, telling me na ang laswa ng ginagawa mo. And hindi lang basta ano eh, parang it's more of like no, that time hindi pa talaga siya totally accepted in this community. I don't know now kasi hindi ako active talaga. But before, hindi siya talaga accepted to a point na parang mismo yung ibang tao na kaibigan mo, ka-cosplay mo, and they would just say, magpaparinig sa'yo na may pa-famous, may pa-ano, ito
yes.
Nag-hubad, ito nag... Parang I really didn't like that, so I had to dissociate myself to those people and to those parang mindset. Kasi I am earning this and I am really happy on doing what I love. Mm-hmm. And I'm more of a happy kasi ngayon nakikita ko some cosplayers are actually doing it slowly and slowly, ina-accept na nila yung culture ng that lewd is not really a bad thing, and it's more of like anime is more of a an art and sexy and lewd and everything. It's part of anime. You really can't say na it's not.
This is in sa Japan nga, diba? There's events or activities, and there are cosplayers who are selling photo prints. Most of them do lewd stuff. Parang acceptable na natin eh. But this is the Philippines. We're a conservative country. It just happens like that. So, of course, since we've talked about the this, ano, how do aside from disassociating yourself with people who are openly mocking you, how do you keep your yourself happy despite all of this?
For me, siguro, also an advice to others, just keep doing what you love, and if as much as possible, let's say you can avoid them. Para sa akin eh, for you to be happy and for you to actually become very parang yung taong walang regret sa buhay is not to hear those people who judge you kung wala ka namang ginagawang masama. And para sa akin, it's more of like wag mo nang isipin or wag mo nang don't let other people define you. Kasi at the end of the day, ikaw lang naman talaga yung makakapagpasaya sa sarili mo, di ba? And to love, that's how you earn. So go. As long as hindi naman siya masama. So yeah, go ahead.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so now that we've discussed more yung about your cosplay journey, your career in cosplay, although it's quite long but quite short, moving forward, you're in Manila right now, right?
Yes, I'm actually here in Ortigas right now.
Ortigas. So, what do you do here currently? What are you doing right now?
So, ngayon, actually, this is far more of like, medyo critical siya kesa nung cosplay ko. Kasi, I am now in line for digital marketing. Tapos yung niche ko talaga or like yung mga tao sinaserve ko is those people na sa real estate ng Pilipinas. So I target those people or those big companies such as SMBC, Ayala Land, Alveo. And that's how I help them kasi I do digital marketing for them and then para mag-increase yung revenue nila.
Okay. So, delving further on what you do, no? Is this doing your social media matter or do you build websites? Kasi there are many components sa digital marketing. Eh. There's video, there's websites, there's social media, so on. So, you do those things, no?
Yeah. So, I also build websites for them. But yung pinaka ano talaga ng service ko is the strategy in when it comes to Facebook ads kasi for me digital marketing and then like I mean if mag-post ka eh, sa Facebook mo digital marketing na yun. Mm-hmm. But this one it's more of like the deeper core of Facebook algorithm. Mm-hmm. knowing your target customers, studying them, having this tracking code for us to be able to target those qualified clients for them. So basically, it's more of like branding and then awareness. And then I also help them to convert those people for them to be able to double or even triple their sales or sales revenue.
And so that's basically I would like to ask, comparing to your cosplay career, do you earn the same amount in digital marketing or was it higher? I'm curious.
So it's higher. Mm-mm. Before it's like 5 digits. Now it's more of like 6 digits.
6 figures na. So that's for just one client, no? Or
depending din.
Depende. Okay. Depende din sa commission pati ano, kasi 'di ba, for every sale of a real estate, whether it's condominiums, house and lot, or even just lots, mga commercial spaces, I'm assuming if you're doing commercial spaces din, ano? That's depending on the commission, tama?
Not entirely depending, but I have a business with SMBC na full on, ano kami, partnership kami, and whatever say na nakukuha doon is nakukuha din. So basically, nagkahati kami ng commissions. But some ng mga clients ko, I go on for fixed rates. Ito yung
fixed
mga
rates, oo.
Depende din kung ano yung parang ano ng client mo. Do you want this fixed rate or do you want this commission?
Mm-hmm. Kasi di rin may iwasan yung mga ano eh. For example, ito fixed rate, pero sometimes they will be asking for discounts, considerations, so on and so forth. I was thinking if you're experiencing those kinds.
Of course, may mga ganun talaga. But sa part ko, when it comes to my client and to sa akin, may mga sinasabing, uy, pa-discount naman ako ng services mo.
Ayan tayo eh.
Pero kapag let's say dun sa ano, sa real estate na sa commission basis, hindi pwedeng makakapag-discount sila kasi it's more of like para siyang condo, hindi mo naman pwedeng tawaran yun. So, it's like a developer and then this. Para siyang, basically, we target more of like yung mga parang pre-selling ng mga condos.
Pre-selling, oo.
Tapos yung mga condos. More of like, hindi kami dun sa parang mga bahay na sinisell. Dun kami sa mga parang developers talaga. Yung pwede na nagpapabahay, nagpapakondo, ganun.
Interesting. Kasi these, of course, we are still in the quarantine period. Whether if it's MGCQ, GCQ, ECQ, there's still queue in it. It's quarantine.
Yes,
so
yes.
How is your business doing well during this period?
It's a pandemic-proof business. So I'd be happy to say na I chose this because I knew na kahit pandemic, my business would still run. And especially right now that yung mga kababayan natin, yung mga Pilipino, itong mga developers na to, they really, really digital marketers. Kasi they can't go back anytime soon with, you know, the traditional selling, which is meet up. What they can do is Facebook, Instagram, and then close the clients through Zoom, through calls. So that's where we come in. And that's most likely parang para sa akin, ito yung time na parang mas accepted kami ng mga digital marketers and parang valued kami in this industry.
Mm-mm. Kasi being digitally adept, ano, you can ask your current client na not that tech savvy to assist you. Eh, hindi nga kayo pwede magkita in person, so might as well do it online. And it's already the age of content. I keep saying the age of content, pero it already has happened to us. Kasi yung, di ba, daming mo makikita sa Facebook, social media. So, let me ask your estimate. Before the quarantine and during quarantine, sumabog ba yung Facebook newsfeed mo?
What do you mean sumabog yung Facebook?
I mean, maraming mga posts and all.
Of course. And these people, yung mga nakakausap ko ngayon na their realtors, they're the ones who's really trying to find us. And they're the ones who's really in need of us, of our services. And nakikita ko talaga na sumasabog yung mga pa-sponsor na budget. Actually, even the developers right now are allocating budget just for this kind of services and just for this kind of operation. So I would likely to say na nag-boom talaga yung digital marketing during this pandemic. Though I can't really say na parang para sa lahat it's there, it's booming. But if I were to compare nung una pa lang nagta-transition pa lang ako sa digital marketing, it was for me mas ano siya ngayon, mas exciting siya ngayon. Mas valued ka kaysa before. Kasi nung dati, ano lang ako eh, Upwork lang ako. If you guys are familiar with Upwork, dun ako, Upwork ako, and then I do lead generation, and that's it. But right now, I can talk to them, the decision makers. I pitch my services to the sales directors of the developers, and then I work with tons of associate sales directors, which is very great kasi hindi ka magkakaroon ng multi-million project just by going to Upwork. And then right now, nakikita ko na, hey, this is actually possible if you would just position yourself, and then ngayon na mas valued yung digital marketers in our industry.
Ayun. So, since of course, nag-next level ka na, of course, you have to level up as well your skills para maging terno din at para magterno ka rin sa mga decision makers and all that. So I've recently stumbled upon your post and you've graduated from this digital marketer course na because of that I also went in and unfortunately hindi ko lang siya natapos. So how did you finish it? How long did you spend your time honing your skills, especially during this period?
Actually, to tell you this honestly, sa yung ano na yun, yung parang course na yun, it was just like a challenge doon sa group namin. Oy, ano kayo dito? Parang watch niyo tong course na to, tapos kunin niyo yung ano na to, yung certificate. But I couldn't really say na doon talaga na ano yung skills ko. But more of like, nung pumunta ako dito sa Manila, even before, nung nasa Tacloban ako, di ba, parang Upwork ako. But nung pumunta ako dito sa Manila, I literally don't have any skills sa Facebook ads and anything about handling clients. Kasi lead generation lang ako noon, Upwork lang. Mm-mm. I didn't really had an experience sa clients ko. I don't know what to do. And then, honestly, I didn't really know how to start. And I went here na may 5,000 pesos lang ako sa bank account ko. Because I was like, I really, really stopped cosplaying that time. And I just really wanted to transition to a more productive parang thing for me na I can really say na, hey, tumutulong ako sa ekonomiya ng Pilipinas. Parang ganun. So, yeah, I stumbled on that course, but it's not like parang.
Kumbaga hindi yung ano sa hindi yun yung defining na course na sa. So, am I correct to say na you also took other courses?
Of course, actually, I took some courses, but it's more of like doing it talaga. In like doing it actually, like actual stuff, talking to clients, and then right after that, yun parang ikakalikutin mo yung Facebook, kakalikutin mo yung ano, yung mga kailangan kalikutin just for you to learn. So I am more of like a learner na ginagawa ko, but of course, yung mga courses na yun, it really helped up naman, but I can't really say na yun yung pinaka-key ko. Because I also have with me my digital marketing partner na siya talaga yung tumulong sa akin para i-hone yung skills ko. Na para kapag, ano yung, may client time na nung gagawin ko. So, more of like, it was the key for me to be able to transition. And those course, it will help. But, yeah. just do it. Like, go ahead and do more of it, research more of it, and then keep doing it. Pagkalikot ka dyan or whatever. Something like that for me.
Mm-mm. So, okay. So, now we've discussed your career after cosplay. Moving forward, if you are to look at your life so far, what will be your life lessons?
Life lessons.
Mm-mm. Lessons in life. You can share with every one of us watching and listening through this episode.
For me, para sa akin, siguro yung number one life lesson ko is siguro kapag some people say na graduate ka, you already finished you passed the board exam, doesn't really mean you're successful already. It doesn't stop there. It doesn't stop in just finishing your course, your college, your board exam, whatever. It doesn't stop there. And I have to say na yung totoong success talaga is right after college and right after doing this stuff na nasa school, because it didn't really help me transitioning to what I love right now. Number two would be take a risk. If you have that kind of mindset na I'm so scared to do this kasi even though it's really your dream, pero hindi mo alam kung paano ka mag-umpisa and hindi mo alam kung paano. Ask people. Try to find a way na you connect to the right people. And also, kapag nakuha mo na, kapag nalaman mo na yung paano mag-umpisa, sunggaban mo na and take a risk. Kasi if you're going to have this parang mindset na, ay, 20 pa lang naman ako, 22, 23, marami pa akong panahon para mag-improve. Ano lang muna ako sa work, parang kuha lang muna ako ng work na hindi ko gusto. I would say, you could have done it early as 22 or 20.
22, okay. So, in that sense, do you have any regrets right now na you could have done this, you could have done that?
Regrets.
Mm.
Siguro, yung regret ko lang sa buhay ko is I was too ambitious na I lost someone very, very special to me, very close to me, just because I was pursuing my dreams. And just because hindi ko kayang ma-appreciate yung time na meron ako at meron yung loved ones ko. So, siguro yung pinaka-regret ko lang is I was very focused on something else. And for me, if I'm going to tell the listeners right now, for you to be happy talaga is, it's not about just being, achieving what you love. It's about the balance of appreciating what you have right now and those people you have here right now and those, yung mga pangarap mo. And I would say na if I'm going to turn back time, I think mas pipiliin kong yung relationships na kinikrave ko and kinikrave din ng that special person to me.
Mm-hmm. So ayun, no, on a higher note, any final words para sa ating mga listeners, viewers? I guess I'll give you the time to promote your social media as well.
Yeah. So, siguro, ay, paano ko ba sasabihin to? hindi ako makalim mag-promote eh.
Okay, pero yun eh. Pero you're into this ano, di ba? Pero it's okay. Go for it.
So, listeners there, if you think na may kakilala kayo na more of like, ano sila sa real estate, they're part of a big developers, and they're having a problem with lead generation right now and getting new customers kasi nga pandemic and wala tayong ibang masasaligan kundi Facebook and digital marketing and Instagram and YouTube marketing. You can absolutely contact me kasi I am here to help our people here, mga Pilipino, mga realtors. And I am here to actually mag-revolutionize ng way of doing our transactions with your clients. Since there's going to be an easy way and dapat matagal na itong in-implement. But right now, I'd say, contact me and we will change your game plan.
Ayan, so with that said, thank you very much, Jasteanne Benito, and
thank you so much for having me,
Jay. I guess hindi pa ito yung huli nating pag-uusapan, no? Syempre, there are still lots of stories to tell, ano? Eh, of course, this COVID-19 pandemic has put us stuck in our homes, only going outside for the necessary things to do, buying groceries and all that. I'm sure you're doing that on your end as well. Pero with these stories in mind, I'm sure enough na we can entertain everyone, our listeners, our viewers, and as well as inspire to not just get stuck at home and do nothing. So again, Jasteanne Benito, maraming salamat.
Thank you so much, Jay, for this amazing opportunity to be part of your podcast. And I really, really appreciate na kinuwawa ko dito. I'm really grateful for that. And yeah, to our listeners, thank you so much for listening as well. And I hope na inspire kayo sa story ko. And yeah, keep doing what you love. And kahit nandito kayo in this pandemic na parang stuck kayo sa bahay niyo, wag kayong magpatalo. Do something productive. This is the time for you to be able to do something great, and you will never know. Kasi for me, para sa akin, ginawa ko to. I transitioned myself from cosplay to digital marketing nandito sa bahay, lockdown. And if I can do that, you can do that too.
That wraps up another episode of Keepsakes, the podcast. New episodes can be heard at anchor.fm/keepsakes, Google Podcasts, Apple Podcasts, and Spotify. Don't forget to visit me on social media for updates. Facebook.com/keepsakesbyj, Twitter @jagonoy, youtube.com/jagonoy, and my blog at jagonoy.xyz. I hope you enjoyed listening to this podcast. Until next time.